إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. يقول الله سبحانه وتعالى الجبار: لقد من الله على المؤمنين إذ بعث فيهم رسولا من أنفسهم يتلو عليهم آياته ويزكيهم ويعلمهم الكتاب والحكمة وإن كانوا من قبل لفي ضلال مبين. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to the believers, to everyone, to the mankind, and specifically to the believers, because they used this advantage. Certainly did Allah confer great favor upon the believers. It is a favor for all mankind, but who used this favor? This favor only the believers, the Muslimun, the Mu'minun. When he sent among them a messenger from themselves as a human being, they know who is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. They know him, they know his father, they know his mother, they know his behavior alayhi salatu wasalam. A messenger from themselves reciting to them his verses and purifying them and teaching them the book, which means the Quran, and wisdom, al-hikmah, which means, as some scholars said, as-sunnah, teaching the believers the Quran and the sunnah, his hadith sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, although they had been before in manifest error. It was abyss before the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They worship anything. They kill the innocent, they ignore the women, they kill their daughters. But when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam was sent to them, he took them from the darkness to the light alayhi salatu wasalam. So this messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, what should we do toward him alayhi salatu wasalam? We have to obey him, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us to obey Allah. We should obey Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, wa ati'u Allah wa rasulah, and obey Allah and his messenger. Another ayah Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, may yuti'u rasul faqad ata'a Allah. He who obeys the messenger has obeyed Allah. So you should, as a Muslim, to obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and his messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then he said in the same ayah, وَمَنْ تَوَلَّى فَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ عَلَيْهِمْ حَفِيظًا. But those who turn away, we have not sent you over them as a guardian. Which means it is your problem if you don't obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and if you don't obey Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You have to obey Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Why should we obey Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? وَأَطِيعُوا اللَّهِ وَالرَّسُولِ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ. It is not a punishment. It is not to make our life difficult. He said, and obey Allah and the Messenger that you may obtain mercy. So there is the mercy The happiness in obeying Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If you obey him, you can obtain the mercy of Rasulullah, of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is not difficult. It is not punishment. It is not against your fitrah, your nature. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also told us toward him, toward the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, فَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا بِهِ وَعَزَّرُوهُ وَنَصَرُوهُ وَاتَّبَعُوا النُّورَ الَّذِي أُنزِلَ مَعَ أُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُفْلِحُونَ. This ayah tells you why should we follow the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? To get the success. If you like to win, to be one of the winners of this dunya and the akhirah, follow Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So they who have believed in him, honored him, supported him. So he has many rights. Alayhi salatu wa salam. It is not only to name our children Muhammad. It is not only to post the name Muhammad on our t-shirt or the mobile. No, we have to believe in him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Honored him. Support him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, so they who have believed in him, honored him, supported him, and followed the light which was sent down with him. Subhanallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not say followed him, followed the light. Which means if you follow Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you are following the light. You will live in light. You will avoid the darkness. You can enlighten your life by following Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It is those who will be the successful. The mercy where? In following Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The success where? In following Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Also paradise where? In following Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Also another ayah, قُلْ أَطِيعُوا اللَّهِ وَأَطِيعُوا الرَّسُولِ فَإِنْ تَوَلَّوْا فَإِنَّمَا عَلَيْهِ مَا حُمِّلَ وَعَلَيْكُمْ مَا حُمِّلْتُمْ وَإِنْ تُطِيعُوهُ تَهْتَدُوا. Say, obey Allah and obey the Rasulullah. But if you turn away, then upon him is only that duty with which he has been charged, and upon you is that with which you have been charged. It is not a sin for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam if all the mankind disobey him. His duty is to convey the message of Allah, and our duty to follow him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَإِن تُطِيعُوهُ تَهْتَدُوا. And if you obey him, you will be rightly guided. If you like to be guided, follow him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Success, guidance, mercy, everything good in following the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And it is wajib to follow the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And this is the sign that you love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قُلْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهِ فَاتَّبِعُونِ يَحْبِبْكُمُ اللَّهِ. This ayah, the scholars or some scholars put this as a title, or as they call it, as ayatul mihna wal imtihan. This is like an exam for everyone. It claims I love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Anyone claims loving Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we test him by reciting this ayah. قُلْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهِ فَاتَّبِعُونِ يُحْبِبُكُمُ اللَّهِ. Say, O Muhammad, if you should love Allah, then follow me. Are you following the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in his salah, how to pray? In his zakah, how to give the zakah? Are you following the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in his behavior? Smiling, treating people politely, speaking nice to the wives, alayhi salatu wasalam,
Are you following the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Qiyam al-Layl, doing the night prayer? Are you following the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in treating the non-Muslims, the animals? You should follow the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in everything, not in one side and you ignore many sides. If you follow him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what will happen? يُحْبِبُكُمُ اللَّهُ وَيَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ. Allah will love you and forgive you your sins. Allahu Akbar. If we follow the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, al-Rahmah, al-Hidayah, al-Mahabba, you'll get a lot of things. You will be guided. You'll get the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah will forgive your sins. When you follow the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But if you avoid following the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, there is a severe torment. فَلْيَحْذَرِ الَّذِينَ يُخَالِفُونَ عَنْ أَمْرِهِ أَنْ تُصِيبَهُمْ فِتْنَةٌ أَوْ يُصِيبَهُمْ عَذَابٌ أَلِيمٌ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, so those who go against the command of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam should fear that Allah can afflict them with trials. What kind of trial? Disbelieve in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Doing bid'ah, innovations. Disobeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Following the desires. And staying away from the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Or with a painful punishment they cannot bear. If you don't follow the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the guidance, the mercy, the love of Allah, forgiveness in following the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the trials, the punishment if you disobey him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. أقول ما تسمعون استغفر الله لي ولكم. الحمد لله وحده والصلاة والسلام على من لا نبي بعده أما بعد. Brothers and sisters, we have to follow the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. There is a misconception that we should follow the Quran and the Sunnah, we should not follow that. It is optional. If you like, you follow, you will get the reward. If you don't follow, you are not a sinner. And this is wrong concept. We have to follow the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَمَا آتَاكُمُ الرَّسُولُ فَخُذُوهُ وَمَا نَهَاكُمْ عَنْهُ فَانْتَهُوا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned about the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and whatever the messenger has given you, take it, and what he has forbidden you, refrain from. Follow the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in a very dangerous hadith. If you miss this hadith, من أطاعني فقد أطاع الله وَمَنْ عَصَانِي فَقَدْ عَصَى اللَّهِ. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, whoever obeys me, obeys Allah. And he who disobeys me, disobeys Allah. If you disobey the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you are disobeying your Lord, the Creator, subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said, كُلُّ أُمَّتِ يَدْخُلُونَ الْجَنَّةِ إِلَّا مَنْ أَبَى. قالوا ومن يأبى يا رسول الله؟ قال من أطاعني دخل الجنة ومن عصاني فقد أبى. All my people will enter paradise. All my people will enter paradise except those who refuse. Who refuses to enter paradise? Who refuses that silk, gold, palaces? No doubt he is crazy. He is a mad. كل أمتي يدخل الجنة إلا من أبى. قال ومن يأبى يا رسول الله. Oh رسول الله, who rejects to enter paradise? No doubt he is a loser. He said صلى الله عليه وسلم, من أطاعني دخل الجنة. He who obeys me will enter paradise, and he who disobeys me, he refused. It is his problem. This is his mistake. The one who refuses to enter paradise by disobeying Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And some people differentiate between the Quran and the Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Subhanallah, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam informed that before more than 1400 years. أَلَا يُوشِكْ رَجِلْ مُتَّكِعْ عَلَىٰ أَرِيكَتِهِ. Beware, I have been given the man, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, a man sitting on his furniture saying, beware, I have been given, sorry, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, at the beginning of the hadith, beware, I have been given the Quran and something like it. He means the sunnah, the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then he described us, the man and people who are doing like this man. Yet the time is coming when a man replete on his couch will say, keep to the Quran. Stick to the Quran. It is enough. Don't follow anything from the Sunnah. We are not sure about the Sunnah. Scholars are different about the Sunnah. So stick to the Sunnah. Quran is enough. The book of Allah. Subhanallah. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us about this kind of people. He said about this man and this kind of people, keep to the Quran. What you find in it to be permissible, treat as permissible. And what you find in it to be prohibited, treat as prohibited. Subhanallah. This is happening now, you find some people like that. But alhamdulillah, Islam is clear. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, the Quran and the Sunnah, you have to follow both of them. He said, I have something like the Quran. What does he mean, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? He means both of them from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Quran and the Sunnah. Allahumma aghfir lil mu'mineen wal mu'minat wal muslimin wal muslimat al ahya'i minhum wal amwat. Innaka sami'un qareebun mujibud da'awat ya rabbal alameen. اللهم اجعل هذا البلد آمنا مطمئنا وسائر بلاد المسلمين. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. اللهم وفق ولاة أمورنا لما تحب وترضى. اللهم ارحم موتانا واشف مرضانا وعاف مبتلانا. اللهم نجي إخوانا المسلمين في كل مكان. اللهم احفظ الشباب والبنات يا رب العالمين. وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين.